Hello and welcome to the video abstract to quantification of dissipation and deformation in ambient atomic force microscopy. This work concerns quantification of mechanical phenomena in the nanoscale with atomic force microscope. First, take a look at an example of force distance dependencies between a sphere of nanoscale dimensions and a surface as the sphere vibrates over it. As mechanical contact occurs, the sphere and surface deform. The maximum deformation delta M and the dissipative processes occurring in the mechanical contact are typically unknown. These parameters are characteristic of the sample being probed, and thus the quantification can provide important information. In this slide, a geometrical scheme of the system is shown. The tip of the AFM is modeled as a sphere of radius R. The tip sample interaction, FTS, is in general unknown. One of the main dissipative processes that have been identified as dominant in the interaction in AM-AFM is viscoelasticity. The energy dissipated via viscoelasticity, E eta, is linear in the viscous coefficient theta and varies with the square root of the oscillation amplitude A and quadratically with the maximum deformation per cycle, delta M. Another prevailing dissipative process in the contact is surface energy hysteresis. The energy dissipated due to surface energy hysteresis is linear in delta gamma, where gamma is the surface energy, and maximum deformation, delta M. The energy dissipated in the interaction can be computed from the known experimental parameters. By equating this energy with the energy dissipated via viscoelasticity and surface energy hysteresis, the unknowns can be recovered. We can define a parameter Kij that depends only on known experimental parameters. From this parameter, the sample deformation can be quantified. From the identity Kij minus Kik equals 0, it follows that only 3 data points are required to extract the deformation. Once the deformation and the value of Kij are known, the difference in surface energy, delta gamma, and the viscosity coefficient, eta, can be readily computed. An example of a typical amplitude versus cantilever separation ZZ curve is shown in this slide, where the attractive and repulsive branches can be observed. With the amplitude A and the phase phi, which is not shown here, the energy dissipated can be computed. Where the viscoelasticity and surface energy hysteresis are present as the main dissipative mechanisms in the repulsive regime can be qualitatively established with the use of standard techniques. Finally, the deformation, viscous coefficient eta, and variations in surface energy, delta gamma, can be quantified. We expect that our work will have implications on a theory on the interface between atomic and macroscale phenomena.